This is Duke University.
Thank you. light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us pray. Almighty God, we give you thanks for surrounding us as daylight fades with the brightness of your Vesper light, and we implore you of your great mercy that as you enfold us with the radiance of this light, so you would shine into our hearts the brightness of your Holy Spirit. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Old Testament lesson is from 1 Samuel, the first chapter. There was a certain man of Ramathaim, a Zuphite, from the hill country of Ephraim, whose name was Elkanah, son of Jeroham, son of Elihu, son of Tohu, son of Zuph, an Ephraimite. He had two wives. The name of one was Hannah, and the name of the other, Peninnah. Peninnah had children, but Hannah had no children. Now this man used to go up year by year from his town to worship and to sacrifice to the Lord of hosts at Shiloh, where the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were priests of the Lord. On the day when Elkanah sacrificed, he would give portions to his wife Peninnah and to all her sons and daughters. But to Hannah, he gave a double portion because he loved her, though the Lord had closed her womb. Her rival used to provoke her severely to irritate her because the Lord had closed her womb. So it went on year after year. As often as she went up to the house of the Lord, she used to provoke her. Therefore, Hannah wept and would not eat. Her husband, Elkanah, said to her, "Hannah, why do you weep? Why do you not eat? Why is your heart sad? Am I not more to you than 10 sons? After they had eaten and drunk at Shiloh, Hannah rose and presented herself before the Lord. Now Eli the priest was sitting on the seat beside the doorpost of the temple of the Lord. She was deeply distressed and prayed to the Lord and wept bitterly." This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The New Testament reading is from 1 John, the 3rd chapter. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is right is righteous, just as he is righteous. Everyone who commits sin is a child of the devil, for the devil has been sinning from the beginning. The Son of God was revealed for this purpose, to destroy the works of the devil. This is the word of the Lord. Please stand for the reading of the Gospel. This lesson is from the Gospel of Luke, the 2nd chapter. When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, Mary and Joseph brought Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that in the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." This is the word of the Lord.
Let us pray. Caring God, your servant, Hannah, came to your temple at Shiloh with deep distress and bitter weeping. We bring before you all whose posture in prayer this night is one of frustration, sorrow, and loneliness. Watch with all whose minds are on loved ones far away. Comfort families that are separated by miles and borders, and bring peace to families whose fights and disagreements leave separations as real as physical distance. We pray especially for the parents and siblings of runaways, for all who are spending the night in a hospital waiting room, unsure if they will see their loved ones whole again. And for any whose friends and family are serving in the armed forces, console any who mourn the death of a loved one or the end of a relationship. Be with us in our loneliness. Be with us when we cannot see you. Turn our helpless lament to a song of praise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, through your servant John, you show us that we are your beloved children, and you promise that what we will be has not yet been revealed. Help us to live faithfully into that identity. We bring before you any who fear that when they are revealed, they will be revealed as failures. Strengthen the hearts of all who fear they have lost their way, and grant your grace to any who experience challenges that charm, talent, intellect, and faith can no longer overcome. Calm the hearts of all who feel trapped in the busyness and competition of college and career. Guide us to trust that you will bring to fullness what you have begun in us, and reveal us at the last as forgiven, loved, and yours. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Rescuing God, your servant Simeon sang of eyes that have seen your salvation. We bring before you all whose eyes long to see restoration and wholeness. Heal our churches and communities as they continue to divide over old arguments. Guide citizens and leaders of nations that face strife and warfare. We name especially before you Egypt, Yemen, Sudan, and the nations of the Middle East and Africa that face unrest, revolution, and violence. Turn the hearts of all to peace, justice, and reconciliation. In the quiet of our hearts, we bring before you the name of one whose healing and salvation our eyes long to see. We surrender our cares to you, trusting in your will and confident in the love that you have shown us in Jesus. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Thank you. Go into this night in peace, and may God give you eyes to see the light of Christ that is our salvation. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.